So today on Redneck Rescue, we're going up a mountain where a side-by-side has slid off the trail. We're not too far off the road, so we're gonna go ahead and just take Miranda and hike the last minute in. But they are right up here, right on this mountain. So we're coming up on the scene. Looks like they're a decent ways up on a pretty steep pitch. Here we go. So this is our side road. We're gonna go ahead and drive right up to this tree and then stop and check out our situation. I feel totally good about backing down this. That's no big deal. And we parked right under that tree because that next bit was pretty steep. And the side-by-side was right up on tree line, just right up there. So this is our scene. We had a nice couple that was coming up here four-wheeling. Trail got a little slick. They went to back up. Back tire went off the edge right here. And they just kind of slid off. They got this pile of rocks under this tire, but that tire is not touching the ground. Being up a decent hill, we're going to go ahead and use its own winch to pull it out. I'm going to run down, grab some tree savers. I think we'll be able to pull the front end up the hill while driving. As you can see, this location is absolutely beautiful. Nice view of the valley. In fact, I can see my house from here. So go ahead and go out first. So we got our Rhino tree saver to a soft shackle to the winch of the four-wheeler. We're gonna go ahead and run one extra safety line just because we're using the winch on the side-by-side. Not sure how it spooled exactly. I rolled it out back in to make sure it was good, but just for safety, we're gonna go ahead and do a safety line. So the key here is to let the winch build tension and then give it a little bit of gas and just go little bits at a time and let the winch work and the motor. As you can see, the material is loose and the tires don't want to steer because the hill is so steep. But with the assistance of the winch, it just pulls nice and steady right up and out. As the front end just slides right over. See that front end wanting to slide over. Without that winch line, that front end would just slide right off and into those bushes right off the road. Right now I'm just trying to get the side-by-side in a straight line with the road so that when I unhook that winch, it's a straight shot down the hill. Which is easier said than done. But we're moving in a positive direction. Oh, we got the winch line all in, unhooked our safety line, and now I'm gonna hop in and back it up. It's gonna be the type of surface that you're not really gonna be able to stop on, so I'm gonna have to keep it pretty straight down the road, and then we'll turn around just right down there. There we go. It doesn't show, but this is pretty steep. So we went to back up, tire slid off here, second tire there, tried to back up some more.
started to teeter once it back in, got past the bush, and they just stopped and gave me a call.
I thought about driving Miranda up. If their side by side didn't have the winch, probably would have. But this is some nice loose material. When I walked down this last time, it was tough not to fall down. It's pretty slick. Rhino USA to the rescue. I don't know if it'll cushion my fall though. Oh man. Just run it out. Today's episode of Redneck Rescue is brought to you by Rhino USA. You can see their products in action today. We used the 10-foot tree saver, a couple of soft shackles. Go ahead into the description below, find a link to their website, and use Rescue 10 to get a discount. I like driving backwards. It don't bother me none. Miles an hour so everybody can see you. And this rescue stuff just takes you to some rough places. I mean, that's just rough, right? They're my favorites. If you enjoyed today's episode of Redneck Rescue, go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button. We got other rescues coming down the line. Have fun out there.